question comes down in the first wave, the second wave, when COVID started last year, a lot of fear went through the society. Oh no, we have to stay at home. We should not get this mask, all that lockdowns and shutdowns. We went through all that. Now we see a trend of that similar fear being instilled in and among the society, especially with Christmas coming in another 2 weeks. Telling, you know, we may have to go for a shutdown, you know, blah, 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 that kind of this thing. Is that the accurate response to this Omicron variant? Because do we have to go back into a lockdown?
So it's, now, when we originally got this COVID issue, we didn't know anything about it. Okay, so when you don't know anything about it, let's say a big, some monster is coming towards you, you are not going to go and face the monster, you're going to hide. So that's exactly what we did. We hid. And then you study the monster remotely. Okay. So we've had time to study the virus, and the amount of things we know about the virus is so much more than it originated. So we know how it is transmitted. We know how it can be prevented. And unlike the earlier stage, we do have some effective drugs as well. So we can use this for the optimum. Now, if we talk about, again, what is happening in Europe. Now, before Omicron came, we know that Austria went for a lockdown. So many other countries went, Europe was having a tough time. That is, again, because of poor vaccination rates. They do have like 70% fully vaccinated, but that includes children. So a large proportion of their adults have not been vaccinated. About one third of their adults who are susceptible to severe disease have not been vaccinated. In Sri Lanka, I think we are better. We understand things and our vaccination rates are better. The other thing is it's winter, you see. And in winter, all these things, respiratory infections cause more devastation. If we look at flu, which all of us are familiar with, you and I have been probably got flu, I don't know, so many times. But every year, it kills around, still up to this date, it kills around 400,000 people every year. Flu kills so much. That is because...
That is normal flu.
That is normal flu, kills around 400,000 people every year. That's a large amount, isn't it? So this is despite there have been vaccines for flu as well. Now, this is because in the winter countries which have winter, because of the cold weather, it causes respiratory infections. Now, we are lucky in that case because we have sunshine and we have a high UV index. And if you look at the weather, it says high UV index. Do not go out between, you know, like from 10 o'clock to like 3 o'clock. And UV is a good killer of virus. Okay, it's like, for instance, in our lab, how we kill the virus is by putting the UV lamp on. It kills virus. So our environment has a high UV index. So that is one advantage we have. The number two advantage is if you look at, if it's like 40, like zero or minus outside, you can't keep your windows and doors open. That is impossible because and so you have airtight rooms, airtight schools, airtight offices in these countries. Whereas our houses, our windows are open, doors are open. If you look at our schools, half wall.
Yes.
Okay, so the wind blows through our schools. And a lot of other offices, not the high-rises in Colombo, but they are very much ventilated. So I think right now, we have to adapt to the situation. So it doesn't mean, so when Omicron comes and maybe something else comes next year, I don't know, very probably, so it doesn't mean that we can go on doing the same thing like we have. So we are at advantage. So then we have to capitalize on our strengths. Our strengths and our advantages is our weather. So and we know that ventilation is very, very important for transmission of this any variant. So we can very well keep the doors and windows open. That makes a huge difference. We know that masks significantly, study after study talk about masks. So those things, ventilation, masks, and keeping a distance when you speak, those simple things can make a big difference.